H.D. Kumaraswamy will be sworn in as the 24th Chief Minister of Karnataka on May 23rd, leading the JDS Congress alliance. Let's take a look at his political career. Kumaraswamy, from the dominant Vokaliga caste, is the third son of former Prime Minister H.D. Deve Gowda. Kumaraswamy is a film producer and distributor turned politician. He first entered politics in 1996 at the age of 37. He came to prominence in 2004 after winning the MLA seat from Ramanagar, a seat which he has never lost. Similar to the 2018 elections, there was a hung assembly in Karnataka in 2004. JDS had entered into an alliance with Congress veteran Dharam Singh as Chief Minister and Siddaramaiah as Deputy Chief Minister from JDS. It was the first ever coalition government in Karnataka. In 2006, Kumaraswamy urged JDS ministers to pull out of the coalition government without his father's consultation or backing. He then formed an alliance with the BJP and became a chief minister on rotational basis in February 2006. The coalition ended bitterly when Kumaraswamy refused to give the chief ministerial seat to Yediyurappa in October 2007. He became president of the JDS in Karnataka between 2008 and 2013 and from 2014 onwards. Let's look at the relationship between Kumaraswamy and Siddaramaiah. There has been a strong rivalry between Siddaramaiah, a prodigy of Deve Gowda, and Kumaraswamy. Siddaramaiah had followed Deve Gowda when he split from Janata Dal Party to form Janata Dal Secular. But Siddaramaiah later accused the father-son duo of preventing him from becoming the chief minister. He was expelled from JDS in 2005, but in a twist of events, he is now giving up his seat to support Kumaraswamy as the new chief minister of Karnataka. Let's get back to the current elections. Kumaraswamy won from both Ramanagar and Chanpatna constituencies, but will resign from one before taking up the mantle of the CM. Some of the promises JDS made in its election manifesto include free power and 30 kilograms of rice to BPL families, a one-time waive-off of all agricultural loans, 6,000 rupees per month for pregnant women 3 months before and after delivery, introduction of spoken Kannada and spoken English in all government schools, 50% rebate on registration of land in the name of women. Given that many are predicting an unstable government in Karnataka for the next few years, will Kumaraswamy be able to fulfill his promises?